What's up, guys? Brandon here with another video. Today we're taking a look at the Disney Collection Buzz Lightyear from JCPenney and the Karate Chop Action Buzz Lightyear from Walmart. So the difference between these two Buzz Lightyears, the one on the right from JCPenney does everything from A to Z. His helmet does the whoosh thing. He's got wings. They expand. They light up. He's got the wrist communicator. He's got Karate Chop Action. But his head sculpt kind of sucks. And then the one on the left, who does pretty much nothing except the Karate Chop Action, has a fantastic head sculpt. So I'm going to attempt to head swap between the two Buzz Lightyears, and I'm also going to attempt to make our JCPenney Buzz glow in the dark. That is the only thing that he doesn't do that the actual Buzz Lightyear does. So bear with me. I'm not a very crafty person. If you watched my last video, you saw I like barely made it. I did a Sheriff Woody head swap, and I got this Sheriff Woody here. I fixed him up. If you watched my last video, you'll know that I heat gunned him and blew up his chest. My grandma helped me stitch this, and it worked out really good. So here's a little time lapse. Enjoy.
What is Roundup?
So yes, Sheriff Woody is all better now. Like I said, we got it stitched under here, and then we cut up another scarf and just attached it to him. Didn't sew it, just cut it and tied it, and he looks great. So I gotta say, I really dig this Sheriff Woody. He's just a regular plush Sheriff Woody with the JCPenney head, but yes, he's brand new and fixed, and very happy to have done that. All right, you guys, bear with me. Are you ready for this? Are you ready for adventure in uncharted space? Let's go! Alright, you guys, so that was pretty easy, simple, straightforward. The Karate Chop Action Buzz has 5 screws on his back. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And that's about it. Once you do that, he immediately comes apart, and then his head is held by these 2 screws, which go right underneath his head. So, really, really happy about that. Hopefully, it won't be too difficult to put this head on that Buzz Lightyear. I'm a little bit more worried now. I mean, this Buzz, there was no electronics, so of course it was simple. But yes, now we got bigger fish to fry. Alright, you guys, so that was really interesting. So the first thing you got to do is remove this screw from Buzz Lightyear's jetpack. Comes right off. Then on the back side of Buzz Lightyear are 4 screws. These 2 are visible, these 2 are hidden. So you remove those screws, and then you get to Buzz Lightyear's butt, and there are 3 more screws. You remove those 3 screws, and Buzz Lightyear comes apart. Once he comes apart, you'll notice that the front and the back are totally detachable. This is his battery in here with the wires. This is his front side. And the cool thing is, the old school Buzz Lightyears had the wires attached right here to the buttons, to the voice box. But not anymore. So you press this, and that is where Buzz's sounds and phrases come from. And then you watched me. I took this part off. It's only connected right here to right here. And that's it. And you just push, apply pressure, and it comes right off. So now we got these 3 screws under here. I'm going to unscrew those and attempt to take Buzz Lightyear's head off. Hopefully that works, and then we'll move forward from there. Very interesting and fun stuff. Okay, so this might be a little bit tougher than intended. I removed this piece from the helmet. Maybe I shouldn't have done that. I'm not sure. And when I did that, I removed the other parts that make the helmet do the whoosh thing. That includes this spring and this. I don't know what that is. And then these two thingies. And I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to put it back together to make it do the whoosh thing. Kind of worried. But underneath Karate Chop Buzz's head is our two screws with one hole in the middle. And then under this one was just one screw. So now this I have to put with this. So from JC Penny Buzz and then Karate Chop Action Buzz. So when I put the two together like this and you look underneath it, you got to make this center hole align with this one. And you're going to need a bigger screw in order to make that happen. So one more time so you can kind of see what I'm talking about here. Focused. So this is what's going on. So I need to find a bigger screw to make this happen. And then we'll go from there. I'm thinking maybe then I will do some of the spray painting because I got all these pieces separated and I can make them all green. So let's see. Alright, you guys, so it worked out somehow, some way. I got this JC Penney plate right here connected to our Karate Chop Buzz. I was just looking on my toy shelves and I found this screw. So what I did was I aligned it like I told you with the third hole in Buzz's head, and I just put it in there and I started twisting. I didn't want to twist too tight, that way he can still look left and right a little bit, but it is very tight and snug in there. And then so now I can put this like this, and it'll line up perfect. And so this is what it's going to look like when it's all done. But for now, I'm going to keep these pieces separate, and I am going to start frog taping this Buzz Lightyear. That way we can make him glow in the dark and put some green paint on there. So, but yes, this is what it's going to look like when it's all done, and I think it looks really awesome. The purples match. I wasn't sure if this purple was going to match here, but it does. I am very happy with this, and I'm really looking forward to this Buzz being put back together. Awesome. Alright, you guys, so while that seemed really fast for you, it took me forever. I finally got all the pieces frog taped, so we can go ahead and spray paint now with some glow in the dark spray. I got it right here. It is Krylon Glows glow in the dark spray, so hopefully that works out. I was also talking to another YouTuber. I, like the rest of you guys, go on YouTube and I look up DIYs and see what's going on. So Cad's Toy Reviews, he spray painted some of his Buzz Lightyears or used some hand paint to make his Buzz glow in the dark a little bit better. He told me to get a black light, so I went to Walmart. I got a black light. I guess that's really important when you're spray painting glow-in-the-dark stuff. So hopefully that works out well. He also told me to get some paint brushes, which is exactly what I did, in case you spray and then you get some big blotchy, I guess, pieces of paint on your Buzz Lightyear, you can make it flat and even. So yes, everything has been covered and ready to go, and we're going to see if this works out. So everything came out good almost, and I say almost because probably the most important piece of this did not come out good, and that piece is the chest plate. It is destroyed. It looks zombified. I tried to use a paintbrush here because it got a little blotchy, and it just didn't work out right, so I tried to cake it on and it didn't work out. It should come out smooth like this, but it didn't. And if I try and peel this off, it's just going to take the paint off altogether. So I'm going to try and get a replacement chest plate soon, hopefully. Yeah. All right, so our replacement JCPenney Buzz has arrived from jcpenney.com for only $21. So fingers crossed this works out. We're going to use the second chest plate and hopefully that works. Fingers crossed, second time's a charm, right?
I was on top of the world, living high. It was right in my pocket. I was living the life. Things were just the way they should be. Some strange things are happening to me. I had friends, I had lots of friends, now all my friends.
So I decided to use those little Try Me arrows to cover the Lightyear symbol. I'm not going to peel the Lightyear symbol off. I'm not going to put frog tape over it. Thought that was the easiest way to do it. And then I am keeping a set of buttons in here, and I'm going to spray like that. I've got another set of buttons that will replace these. When I tried to do it the first time and I left these open, I put buttons back in. It didn't work out, and the buttons got stuck in there, and they didn't work. So fingers crossed this works out. Let's see.
It's all gone.
So I'm attempting to put Buzz back together. I've got this helmet here for reference. I got to put all of this together and make sure the Buzz's head can turn, make sure everything's connected underneath. I got to figure out how to put this helmet together and make it do the whoosh thing. That's why I got this for reference. Hopefully that'll help me, seeing where the springs and the screws are. That's going to be very useful. I also swiped one of these buttons off of the other Buzz's chest plate. This is the replacement Buzz, because he has the capability to speak English and Spanish. But when you get this JCPenney Buzz, he only speaks English. They don't include one of the buttons. So like I said, I swiped one of them, and I'm going to put this one onto the chest plate of our Buzz that I still got taped up here. So let's get to it.
And I'm good. Best I can carry on. I had power, I was respected, but not anymore. And I've lost the love, the one whom I adore.
And then that one should make the wings light up. Although when I was taking off some of the frog tape, I cut some of the laser sticker. So, good thing I got a replacement. I got like two spare Buzzes as fodder for this. Just in case I messed up. Like I told you guys in the beginning, I'm not a crafty person. So, it's a good thing I got some extras. And I think while I'm at it, I might use this Space Ranger sticker as well. That looks a lot more accurate from the Karate Chop Buzz.
Let me tell you about a strange thing that happened to me. Someone you think you know well, turns out a stranger. The minute you turn your back, you're in it all by yourself. They laugh at your jokes, you think you're doing quite well, but you're in danger, boy. You end up alone, forgotten, way up on the shelf.
You guys, lo and behold, Buzz Lightyear is complete. I am super, super happy with how this project came out. It was really frustrating at some parts and really rewarding at others. So we're going to go through Buzz Lightyear A to Z. I'm going to show you everything that I've done. So this is our brand new Buzz Lightyear. He's got a brand new face sculpt. I really like it. Unfortunately, I was not able to get this whoosh thing to happen here for his visor. So it opens and closes. There's a spring here. I was able to put that back, which keeps the helmet down. Keeps it down flat so it doesn't, you know, pop up. But there's another spring here that I just could not figure out. I even looked at the other Buzz Lightyear here and modeled it after that. I did it exactly the same way, and it just did not work out. But yes, so here he is with all of his glow-in-the-dark green trim. Some of these stickers were a major nightmare. The laser sticker was a nightmare. So was the Space Ranger one. The Lightyear sticker stayed great. The Space Ranger one I took off and put back. The jet exhaust ones almost came off. Thankfully, they didn't. His wings still work. They both work great. And these stickers came off when I was peeling them off, so I had to get them from the other Buzz. So I'm really glad I had a replacement Buzz Lightyear. And then he also does speak Spanish and English now.
Hasta el infinito y más allá. Please be careful. You don't want to be in the way when my laser goes off.
He still has a functioning Karate Chop action, which is awesome. Very happy about that. And he still has his wrist communicator completely intact. There we go. Yes, with the sticker in there. And all in all, you guys, I was trying to make a Buzz Lightyear that was as accurate to the movie as possible. Pretty much since I was a little kid, I wanted a Buzz Lightyear that was movie accurate. And over the years, I've had so many Buzz Lightyears that I had gripes about. I got a Buzz like this from the Disney store back in 2010, and I thought it was perfect. I just didn't like his face sculpt and that he couldn't glow in the dark. And that's pretty much been the driving force since I was a kid between then and now. And I am very, very happy with the outcome. So I've got Buzz here in the dark. He does glow. I'm showing you with a black light, that way you can kind of see what I did. But pretty much all of the green accents have all been spray painted with a glow in the dark green. And it came out really nice, really clear, even up here at the helmet. I just really, really like it a lot. Here's Buzz's backside, which also came out really, really nice. I really do like that a lot. Even the wingtips came out great, and the wings still light up, which I am extremely happy about. All in all, this Buzz Lightyear just came out tremendously well, and I am extremely happy.
Remember what your old pal said, boy, you got a friend in me.
For a size comparison, here is our brand new Buzz Lightyear next to the Sheriff Woody that falls over, the interactive one that falls over. I did a review about him. We also have the Thinkway Bo Peep. I reviewed her as well. And then I also have here probably the best Sheriff Woody of all. I've got the custom Woody from my last video. Please feel free to check out my latest video prior to this one. This Woody is absolutely fantastic and definitely fits in very well with this Buzz Lightyear. Additionally, I got some other characters here like the Thinkway Jessie. She also fits in very well. It's just such a screen-accurate Buzz Lightyear to me, you guys. I just absolutely love it. He fits in very nicely with the evil Emperor Zurg. And, of course, Forky is always a nice addition as well. So very, very cool stuff. Very happy to have this Buzz Lightyear completed and in my collection. It's probably something I forgot to say at this point, but Buzz's head does rotate. Just the point of articulation that I really wanted to keep. That screw that I randomly found on a toy shelf allowed me to do that. So I much rather prefer that than, you know, hot gluing him on there. So I think that's really, really awesome. You guys, thank you so much for following along with me on this journey. I am super happy to have brought this Buzz Lightyear to you all. If you have any questions, please let me know. Comments, concerns. I'd love to know what you think. If you're going to do this yourself, if you think you're capable. Trust me, I'm not a crafty person, and I pulled it off. Except for that helmet. That really bugs me. Not sure what I'm going to do about that. But yeah, if you have a way to help me fix that, please let me know too. You guys, I'm over 1,200 some subscribers because of you, and it is absolutely incredible. Blows my mind. Thank you to all the fans out there, all the superhero, geeky, nerdy, Toy Story fans. I just love you guys, so thank you. As I find more new cool stuff, I will absolutely review it, so keep it right here at my channel. Once again, I'm Brandon, and thanks for watching.